Welcome students, I welcome you in class 6. Today we shall start biology assignment 1, chapter 1, the leaf. First we shall learn about the parts of a plant. After that we shall learn about the parts of a leaf. You already know about the parts of a plant. Plants have roots, stem, buds, flowers, fruits. So, parts of a plant, root system and shoot system. Root system. The part of a plant which grows under the ground is called root. Root grows downwards away from sunlight and towards the force of the gravity. The root system is of two types, tap root system and fibrous root system. First, you observe the diagram of tap root system. The tap root system has a thick main root called primary root. Primary root produces branches called secondary roots. These are the side branches of primary root called secondary roots. So, this type of root system is found in dicot plants such as pea, gram, beans. Dicot plants. Plants having two cotyledons in their seeds called dicot plants. Observe the next diagram, fibrous root system. The fibrous root system has a cluster of roots of the same thickness and size arising from the base of the stem. So, this type of root system is found in monocot plants such as rice, grass, maize, monocot plants. Plants having one cotyledon in their seeds called monocot plants. Now, the functions of root. The roots hold the plant firmly in the soil. So, root fixes the plant in the soil. Another function of root. Root absorbs water and minerals from the soil for the growth of entire plant. You know about photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process by which plants prepare their food. So, plants prepare their food in their green part for which they absorb water through roots. So, I hope this portion is clear to you. So, next portion, shoot system. The part of a plant which grows above soil forms the shoot system. So, shoot system is made up of stem, buds, leaves, flowers and fruits. Stem is the main aerial part of shoot system. Now, the functions of stem. Stem bears all the aerial parts of the plant such as buds, leaves, flowers and fruits. Another function of stem. Stem helps in the upward movement of water and minerals absorbed by the roots and transports them up to the leaves. Food prepared by the leaves is transported downwards to the roots and the other parts of the plant by the stem. Now, notes. The points on the stem from where the leaves and branches originate are called nodes. Now, internode, the part of the stem between two successive nodes is called an internode. So, the portion of the stem between any one node and the next node is called internode. So, node, node, here, internode. Node, node. And here, internode. Apical bud or terminal bud. The tip of the shoot has buds called terminal buds or apical buds. They are responsible for the vertical growth of stem. Axil. The angle between the upper side of the leaf and a stem is called the axil. The buds found here are called the axillary bud. An axillary bud is present here. Now, petiole. The basal part of a leaf is a stalk, is called petiole. It is attached to the stem at the node. Now, lamina. The flat, green, broad part of the leaf is called lamina or leaflet. The outer edge of the lamina is called leaf margin. Leaf apex, this is leaf apex. Now, midrib or petiole continues into the lamina as the midrib. This is midrib. The midrib divides into several lateral branches which are called veins. Further branches of veins are called veinlets. Petiole, midrib, veins and veinlets conduct food and water. Now, veins provide a supportive framework to the leaf. So, I think this portion is clear to you. So, I will give you some question. You write the answer in your exercise book. To try to write the answer, later I shall check them. Thank you.